Hi, this is Grum, and you're with DJ Relax on Release.
The number you have reached has been disconnected. The new number is...
The Phone Booth.
In sunny Down Under, we're talking to Grum. How are you, sir?
Hey, I'm not too bad, thanks.
Thanks for joining us back here, mate. I think last time we caught up, you were having the breakout from blogosphere into, I guess, if you want, the real world or the record company world. So how's that transition been for you?
Yeah, it's been pretty cool. I mean, the album's out now, and I've kind of been touring, playing loads of gigs, and it seems like people are really liking the music, so it's been going pretty good.
So the album Heartbeats is the one we're talking about. You had obviously the single off that, which sort of broke you through, Heartbeats. Also, you've had since then Can't Shake This Feeling, and now Through the Night as well. So you've been happy with the end product?
Yeah, I kind of wanted to combine all the influences I like, you know, the soft rock and combined with sort of modern dance music, and yeah, turned out pretty cool, I think. Through the Night singles coming out pretty soon, and that seems to be going down well. Got a really cool video.
Yeah, and I was just going to talk about that. I just had a bit of a look at that. That's it's a sort of 80s cop gone wrong, almost, if you will, without giving away too much in there.
I guess that people are calling it a bromance.
Yep, there it is. Absolute bromance, through and true. Now, I guess that's one part of the world that you're now tipping your toe into, is the video side of things. Must be a bit of fun too. Any inklings for you to do any cameos, do some Oliver Stone cameo type work? Or?
That would be really cool, actually. Maybe the next one.
Yeah, maybe when it's not bromance, maybe. Yeah. We are talking to Grum in the Phone Booth on Release. He is touring around the country currently. Check your gig guides to find out exactly where he's playing. He's coming down very soon. He's halfway through it. How are you finding this is now, what, your third trip, is it, perhaps, to Australia?
Yeah, it's the third tour I've done over here. Yeah, the flight over doesn't ever get any better, so that's still the same. But, yeah, the gigs have been amazing so far.
And have there been any antics or... chances to catch up with people, I guess, at the backstage festivals? It's all about the antics behind the stage, I guess. We're all interested to find out about who's doing what and with who. Have you been keeping your nose clean, or what's been going on there?
I've been taking it pretty easy, actually, since I got here, because the flight's kind of destroyed me, not feeling so good. But now we've got to Sydney and I've had a rest, I'm ready to go, so the next few days should be fun.
Well, look out Sydney. And then you are ending up in Adelaide. Is going to be the end of the tour for here, so for those of us listening over here, we'll be hoping, I guess, that feeling of, oh good, this is all over, and you can really let your hair down, to come through for us.
Yeah, well, I have to leave the next day, so probably won't be going too crazy, but yeah.
You're remixing just absolutely everyone and anyone at the moment, and it's sort of from the underground, i.e. the sort of the Anoraks, your Freelands, Adam Freelands, to, you know, your more mainstreams, i.e. Lady Gaga, Goldfrapp, Groove and Marty. Don't get much bigger than these guys. Passion Pit, or even the Australians, Jump Jump, Dance Dance, and TV Rock in there as well. So, you mean, you're not being biased in any way, shape or form, and are you ever turning any remixes down? Do you have time for that?
I mean, I've had to turn down a few down, but generally it's just if I like the track, then I'll do it. It doesn't matter who it is, you know.
I know you're a fan of Aeroplane. Interesting, I noted recently, he had the crisis dilemma of whether to do a remix for another artist. I don't know if you caught this with Eric Crides.
I saw this, yeah.
What's your take on that then?
I don't know, I don't really think it's that cool to ask on Twitter if you should remix something. You know, that's a personal choice. Yeah, it's just up to you as an artist. You know, you need to stand by what you know and what you like.
Yeah, exactly right. I think that's what you seem to be doing. If you do like it, then why not do it? Whether who they are and what they are, I guess you're putting your influence on it, so it wouldn't matter. But yeah, it was an interesting one for him to put it out there like that, wasn't it?
Yeah, it seemed to cause a bit of a stir.
Yeah. We are talking to Grum in the Phone Booth here on Release, back in the Phone Booth, catching up with him as the album Heartbeats is out and he is touring around the country. And the success is riding higher and higher for the man. As I said, check your guides to find out exactly where, or give us a call here at the station. He is coming up very soon. We appreciate the time, mate. What's next for you when you head back home after this tour in Australia?
Next thing, we're going to get back. I've got doing a remix for Pet Shop Boys. They're re-releasing West End Girls. So I'm really excited to get on with that. So I'm back for a week and then I'm off to the US for a little tour. So it's kind of non-stop.
So you've got a week to do the remix for the Pet Shop Boys, is that what you're saying there? Or you've...
Yeah, just about a week to do that.
And is that a time frame that's doable for you, or...?
Yeah, I've been doing some sort of preparation while I'm on the road here, so it should be okay.
I also understand you mean essentially you can do what you do on the road, you can do at home in the studio. You don't have too much on board, i.e. with your software and production-wise, it's pretty...
Yeah, I run a pretty lean studio. It's just off my laptop, really. So I can do that on the train or the plane, whatever.
Or the 24-hour plane ride home.
Yeah, definitely get those done, as long as my battery doesn't run out.
Mate, well, we look forward to hearing that and look forward to hearing from you again soon. Hopefully you're back in the phone booth with more stuff coming out of your ever-busy fingers, mate. Before we go, I always like to ask, is there something you can play on the show for us?
Sure, yeah. I'm going to go for Aeroplane Superstar, and it's the Craze remix.
DJRelax.com.